In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of pectoralis major, also known as pec major. Pectoralis major or pec major. Okay, this is pec major. This is very big muscle in front of chest. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with other muscle. Okay, let me explain origin. Origin is this part. This is very, very wide origin. The one part of origin is this part. This part is about 2/3 part of clavicle, especially about 2/3 medial part, medial part of clavicle. Then this part is manubrium. Manubrium is the superior part of sternum. Manubrium. And of course, here, sternum. And there is muscle on abdominal area. This is rectus abdominis. Part of pectoralis major attaches on rectus sheath. Rectus sheath. This is basically fascia. You know, fascia. Okay, so this is very wide origin. Medial part of clavicle, manubrium, sternum, and rectus sheath. By the way, it attaches on costal cartilage, okay? So, cartilage, okay? Basically, this area. This is origin of pectoralis major. It's very wide. And insertion is this part. It's smaller than origin, correct? Insertion is smaller than origin. This part is crest of greater tubercle. Crest of greater tubercle. Right here. Crest of greater tubercle. Look at that. This is origin. Very wide. Insertion is small. Okay, now let me explain function of pectoralis major. There are three basic movements. First one is adduction. Adduction is you close arm this way. Okay, when you raise up arm, then cross. This is adduction. Next one is flexion. Flexion is when you raise up arm for forward way. Flexion. Then one more movement is internal rotation. Internal rotation. Internal rotation. Okay, three major movements. But if I want to add one more thing, that does horizontal adduction. Horizontal adduction. What kind of movement is that? Okay, horizontal adduction is when you raise up arm 90 degrees, then you close this way. Imagine you do dumbbell fly, that kind of movement. You abduct arm 90 degrees, then close arm this way. The best way to describe is when you do dumbbell fly. That kind of movement. I explained four movements. Basic three are adduction, flexion, internal rotation. And I added one more movement that is horizontal adduction. This is very, very strong muscle. Now let me explain relationship with another muscle. what I'm going to talk about is I'm going to explain relationship with deltoid, especially anterior fiber of deltoid. Anterior fiber of deltoid. Why? Because there is connection between pec major and deltoid. You see, this is very, very close muscle. I'm going to erase pen so you can see close relationship. You see that there is no separation between deltoid and pec major. Only this space, this tiny space. So what does it mean? You can say if pec major gets tight, shortened, adhesion, that can affect deltoid, especially anterior fiber. Vice versa, if anterior deltoid gets tight, that can affect pec major. Okay, this is very, very common. When I do myofascial release about this area, the connecting point between these two muscles, most of the time, these two muscles are released simultaneously. This is very, very common thing. So, I usually see pec major and deltoid as one continuation, like one continent, one country, if I have to say. So, I hope this idea gives you new idea for your clinical experience. This is very, very good way to see anterior part of chest and shoulder. So, in this video, I explained basic anatomy of pectoralis major, its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with deltoid. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.